Welcome back from that short break. Now, of course, we're still interacting with a very intelligent, brilliant lawyer who's, of course, going to be giving us some, I hope not lawyer kind of advice into this situation, because you all know what our love letter means. And in case you're just joining us at this point in time, one particular lady writes saying that my boyfriend, whom I have dated for 10 months, died 3 weeks ago in a fatal accident. I was devastated, but I met someone who was always there for me. We have been good friends and had good times until last week, when he asked me to be his girlfriend, saying that he loves me. I have fallen for him, but I am worried of moving on since people will start judging me. What should I do? Madam Lawyer, could we go with you first? What do you think this particular lady should do?
Can I plead the fifth?
in this situation, there's no pleading the fifth. Yeah.
Well, I've had that bit where she says that she's afraid of people judging her. Mm. But I think she should always remember that people judge whether you do something or not do it. So why not just take responsibility, decide to do something? At the end of the day, she'll be accountable. She should make a decision that is informed from herself, not from the society, because society is out to judge. Whether you act or omit to act, they'll still judge. So let her just pursue what she wants to do.
But at the end of the day, somewhere society reflects who you are at the end of the day, doesn't it?
Not necessarily. Sometimes you may have to actually force society to understand who you are. Because if you let society decide who you're going to be so many people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then also her moving on into another relationship, isn't that too quick? I mean, this is someone who has just lost someone in a fatal accident.
Well, I would say I could grieve with that person, but if she's ready to move on, what is wrong with that?
Mm.
Yes, there's not too soon, too early, too whatever. She can do whatever she wants at any point. Were they married?
That's a question. That's a beautiful question. No, they were not married. They were actually dating. Well, it's 10 months after, you know, someone has lost, the fellow, and, you know, they're getting into another relationship, but she's afraid of society judging them.
Mm. Well, I think for starters, I keep saying this, that your happiness is not in someone else out there. Your happiness is in you. If you're happy by yourself, that's a good thing. The other thing is that guy died 10 months ago. I'm not saying that's a long time ago, but I'm saying that, 10 months is enough for you to move on. 90 days max, you should have moved on from, some. Of course, the memory is there, but it shouldn't be, obstructing you from doing this and that. I mean, you can't say, I'm going to stop breathing for a full year because he died. Then I'll start breathing next year. No, I think that if she's happy, if her gut tells her this is the right guy, if she thinks this guy is making her happy, move on. Love is not in Kampala or Jinja or Gulu. Love is not in January or February or March. Love is now. If you find it, take it.
But if she's actually failed to move on in this particular case, maybe she's still stuck with the memories of the previous boyfriend.
Well, if she's stuck with the memories of the previous boyfriend, then it's understandable. If she's not ready to move into another relationship, let her take it slow. But if she wants to go into it, let her get into it without having to consider, what is society going to say? Society is a very difficult concept. There are so many people in society. Some want to support her, some are against her. So if she's not ready, it's better to just take it slow.
If someone says you stole a piece of meat from the saucepan, but you didn't, go and steal it. At least you know you're being accused of something you did.
I think the lawyer would beg to be that case.
Go and steal it. I mean, after all, this guy is already judging you and saying what? So in this case, of course, guys are going to see the relationship between her and this guy, whether it's friendship or what. You can't hide love. Guys will see it, they'll suspect it, and they'll start judging her. So why not start the relationship? Why not be in it? Why not own it and leave it? You understand? If you have a guy or don't have a guy, if you take 2 years, guys will say, okay, you're taking too long. If you go 10 months, guys will say it's too quick. So do it at your time. If you feel you're ready, let's go.
The studio lines are definitely open. You can give us a call. The studio number to call is right there on your screen, 0414-333-7872. You can call us right away back and let us know.
I mean, just to interrupt you a bit, their relationships have been in and moved on after a year. But I remember,
You've been in?
Yes.
How many relationships have you been in?
I don't know. I can't count. Many. There are relationships that have lasted a week. And there are some that have lasted a
week. Are those also relationships? Are they also called relationships?
Yeah. You start a relationship and on Friday you're like, but wait, Let's agree to disagree. Let's just move
don't
on.
You have a lawyer jargon to define that? Is it also a relationship?
It's a relationship. I mean, you meet on Saturday, you go out on Sunday, and on Monday you're like, let's do this. Then Wednesday you're like, but wait, you can't be my woman crush Wednesday. On Thursday she's pissed. On Friday you're like, I can't take your anger. Let's just break it off. And you break it off. But there are relationships that have, you know, have ended, and I move on in like 3 days. And get into another and life moves on.
What's the possibility that this guy who's, you know, being there for this lady could be taking advantage of the situation?
Which advantage? Is she paying for any bill?
I mean,
what advantage?
The advantage that maybe she's mourning over the boyfriend or something.
If it's a bang situation, you're also going to enjoy. So what do you mean advantage? unless he's going to rape her, that's a crime. But if they both agree as adults,
did you see the first Shubrah?
Yeah, I know lawyers are like that.
Let's pick our first call and get to find out what they have to say regarding this particular situation. I think we lost that one. Try giving us a call right away. Back the studio line to call is 0414-337-872. Let us know. And of course, remember to turn down the volume on your TV in case you are to communicate with us. Do you have a caller online? Shubrah, in this particular situation, do you think that this is one of those relationships that could even actually last long?
It's possible.
Given the circumstance on where it is built, this is someone just being there for you because, you know, you lost someone and you're not even clear about their intentions. You're probably even confused in that particular moment.
I'd love to say that the starting point is always within us. So this lady needs to understand whether or not she loves this person. Does she enjoy the company of this person, or rather she has feelings for this particular individual? What kind of feelings does she have for him? Okay. Yeah. You may love the fact that he's around you. He could be a good friend. Is he a good boyfriend at the end of the day? Yes. So she needs to understand what's inside her before anything else that is external.
Probably for starters, I think that she should have it at the back of her mind that it's not going to last for long. Because I don't believe in relationships that start like this. If you are still holding on to the fact that the guy died 10 months ago, that's a fresh memory. It means for you haven't moved on. So any relationship you get during that time, you're, should I say, blinded?
Can I say something about that?
Please.
I'm not the relationship expert, but I think any sort of...
I thought you were going to say the relationship type.
Any sort of relationship can last. You see, some people meet in bars and they end up getting married. Yeah. While some people meet in church and their relationship lasts for a week.
Yeah. True story.
So sometimes the note on which you have started may not be the very relevant one. It depends on how you sustain that particular relationship. So we cannot exactly say that it's not going to last. Neither can we say it will last.
No, for me, I come from a point of view that if you start... for example, I'd say my father told me...
Before you get into that story, let me first pick this call and we get to find out what they have to say regarding this one. Hello? Let's reduce the volume on your TV. Hello? Let's have another call. In case you're to call us, ladies and gentlemen, please turn down the volume on your TV so that we avoid that echo. Hello? Hello, good morning. That one, we're having issues with our network, I think. Let's have another call. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, good morning.
Yeah, good morning.
You're live on Urban Television. What's your name and where are you calling from?
You're speaking to Ivan. I'm calling from Kawempe.
Ivan from Kawempe. Interesting. What advice do you have for this lady?
I think relationships are based on mutual understanding, okay? For a lady like that who has just lost someone, she should take her time, okay? Get to understand this person, get to understand what she's looking for in that relationship and what that person is out for. Because at the end of the day, if she rushes, she'll get to, you know, she's still with the other person, those memories. So let her just take her time in this relationship. Take it slow. Get to know this person, okay? But my honest opinion is she should, you know, give herself a second chance and move on.
All right. Thank you very much.
I don't think it's a second. Like I was saying, my dad told me.
Let's first make another call right there. Hello? Hello? Should have been a lady. Could a lady call us, please? I would like to get into. And mine's Lady Ren. Hello? Hello, caller.
Hello?
Yes,
hello.
Good morning.
Hello?
You're live on Aban today?
Hello?
Yes, hello?
Yes.
Hello. Your name and where you're calling from?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yes.
Please reduce the volume on your TV. Please, guys, stop hearing. Try to hear yourself. Eh? It's disturbing. Hello, caller. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, good morning.
Morning to you.
Oh, that's a lady. Yes, how are you?
Doing well.
Fantastic. What's your name and where are you calling from?
I'm Achipo Goretti from Soroti.
From Soroti. What advice do you have for a fellow sister here?
She's gone. Sorry.
From Soroti. It hurts me. But anyway, let's pick another caller right there. Hello? Hello, caller? I think we lost that one. Do we have another caller online? So you were giving us a story.
Yeah, he
about
said,
your father.
He said, never make decisions. Never say anything or make decisions when you're in your extremes. Mm. When you're very sad, when you're heartbroken, never make a decision. When you're very happy and excited in a bar or a party or church, never make decisions. You have to make decisions when you're in a balance, when your soul, spirit, and body are in balance, meaning you're thinking straight and you know your brain is working. Mm-hmm. So he said that, and for me, I see it's a problem here. She is still emotional about the fact that her boyfriend died 10 months ago. She's still bringing it back even before she gets into this relationship. I think she's not yet ready to make a sober decision. I think her judgment is impaired, and she may get into situations that she's not going to be able to get out of. So I suggest let her take her time. Let them be friends. Mm-hmm. Let her enjoy her life. Let her be happy. Mm-hmm. Then if, you know, as time goes on and she becomes happy, things will come through and she'll make a sober decision. But right now, she's just looking for a shoulder to cry on.
You did mention something that, you know, triggered my mind in terms of, you know, this relationship is not going to last based on where it is coming from and what it is being built on. What do you think a relationship that's going to last should be built on?
Well, it should be built on... Built on is relative, like she said. Mm. I mean, people build relationships on religion and whatnot. But for a relationship that would last, for me to start,
where should it start from?
You should be in a, you know, everything should be in like a sober state. Mm. You should not be heartbroken and say, you know what, now I need another girlfriend, bichi bichi, and then you get someone. That relationship will not last, because after 3 weeks, you realize, my ex was better than this one. I need another one. So it will be
you
a cycle.
Keep getting excellent.
Yeah, so what you need to do to start a good relationship is move away, move on, heal, be happy. And when you're happy as an individual, trust me, you'll look for someone to give that happiness.
We're going to pick about two last callers as we get to wrap up with this particular one, and we get to find out what you guys have to say. Hello, we have a caller online.
Hello.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning.
How you doing?
Good.
Your name and where you're calling us from?
I'm Anne.
Yes,
calling from Mango.
From Mango. What advice do you have for this beautiful sister?
Just talking about the issue of the lady. Mm. If inside her she feels that she can go on, she can go on rather than getting hold on something that is past and gone, yet there is something present.
And fresh, eh?
Life goes on, yeah. If inside her... she feels like she can go on, then she can.
All right.
Yeah.
And are you in a relationship?
What?
Are you in a relationship?
Of course.
How long would it take you to, you know, move on from your current boyfriend in case things went south to the next boyfriend?
It depends on how I get healed, how it takes me.
Mm-hmm. You have
get
someone
healed.
Next
if
to you?
If it's a month, if it's a day, it can be hours.
I hope he's not listening in right about now.
Say hi to that lady, Bambi. She's very intelligent and smart.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And she's also.
I wish
Mango.
They don't take you away from Uganda.
She's also from that side of Mango, by the way.
Really?
Yeah, so you guys can meet up for a cup of coffee or something.
I would love.
All right, Anne, thank you very much for calling.
I always disagree with people who say if you feel like. It's very dangerous.
It's very dangerous to feel like. Let's pick another caller right there. But sometimes you feel like coffee.
What if you don't feel like?
Hello, caller. Hello?
Hello.
Yes, good morning.
Yeah, I'd call that Aaron. It's still Ivan here.
Yes, Ivan.
I don't know if it's okay. I wanted just to talk to Shubrah.
Oh, yes, please, she's here.
Yes, I'm right here.
Hey, good morning. I just wanted to say thank you so much. You inspire me so much.
Thank you.
Yeah, and with everything that you're doing, just know you're inspiring so many out here. Please continue advocating for the rights of women. And I believe you are the kind, you know, that we need in this country right now. So, yes, thank you from me.
Thank you. I'm equally inspired.
All right.
Maybe you just give them your handles and, you know, give you a follow.
Clearly on your market. Let's pick another last caller right there. We'll get to wrap up. Hello? Hello? Do we have someone who wants to talk to Willis?
Come on.
Hello? I think we dropped that one. But anyway, we're running out of town.
I feel I love you. I will put you in a rubbish bin the shortest possible time. You either have to love me or not.
Hello?
No.
Yes, good morning. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, you're live on Urban Today. What's your name?
I'm Sylvia from Zambia.
From?
Zambia.
In Zambia. What advice do you have for your fellow sister here?
Actually, that girl should give herself time.
She should give herself time?
Yes. Then she has to move on right away.
Okay. All right, thank you very much for calling. We've run out of time, unfortunately. We're going to cut it down with the phone calls. Shubrah, as we do get to wrap up, your last words for this lady right here, and of course also in regards to, you know, the art of debate. Let's begin with the love letter. Your last words.
My last words to the lady is let her follow her heart. I insist. It's about her. It's not about the society.
Okay.
Yeah, at the end of the day, she'll be accountable to self, because this is about love. It's not about delivery of services to the people.
All right.
Yes.
And in regards to the art of debate...
The art of debate. Young people in high school, primary school, debate, engage in debates, join debate clubs, because debate is their thing, as a certain gentleman said, Ogola, Justice Ogola, with all the due respect. Yes, keep debating, acquire yourselves copies of the art of debate. It's going to help you get to know how you can actually go about this art that you actually need in your lives. If you want to be a lawyer, you want to be a doctor. Doctors also need to express themselves. You want to be a physician. Anything. Be in position to express yourself, because there's power in language. And laxity of words is very problematic.
Wow.
True.
Farouk has laughed. You didn't get the joke. and of course, Ivan, please get a piece of paper, get your phones. Shubrah is going to be giving you her social media handles. You can get in touch with her there and, you know, get to find out more about her. Your social media handles, please.
Yes, I'm on Twitter. So on Twitter, my Twitter handle is @KasoziShubrah.
Okay.
Yes.
There's no underscore. There's nothing. It's just KasoziShubrah.
KasoziShubrah.
All right.
Yes.
Facebook?
No, Facebook.
Not on Facebook.
Yes. Mm. Instagram, KShubrah3.
Okay. Snapchat?
No.
Okay. Wow. But anyway, there you have it. Of course, Abba today is going to go in for a very short break. When we do get back, Nicholas will be coming in back for the latest of what is happening in the world of sports.